The bodies of 9 women have been found in the desert outside Las Brisas. None of them have been identified. Their remains have all been destroyed by the elements.
Well, she couldn't have sent this. Who did?
Someone who has access to police photos. Someone who knows about us. The newspaper articles indicate that a lot of the victims work for Lofton Industries. It's an American company.
On the Mexican side.
Look, Bailey. The families of 15 missing women are begging for answers. And their police chief just keeps telling them that these acts are random. These women are being preyed upon.
According to the State Department, we'd have to contact our legal attaché in Mexico.
So let's contact him.
The chances of our being invited to investigate aren't very good.
We've been invited.
Sam. Donald Lucas's trial is about to start. The most important trial of your life is on the line.
Donald Lucas is in custody. He can't hurt anyone else. This guy can.
Get me our legal attaché in Mexico.
Vamos, muchacha joven. No hay identificación.
Indigente o prostituta. ¿Qué tipo de idiota camina por la noche en el desierto? ¿Y a ella? ¿Quién la invitó?
No fui yo.
Teniente.
Capitán. Quizás ella venía de la fábrica a su casa, pasando por las brisas como las otras.
Es el único pueblo por varias millas.
Tenemos muchos trabajadores que se han desaparecido. No.
Ella no era trabajadora. Un ángel esta vez.
Le traeré unos guantes.
No, gracias. Tenemos otras cosas que hacer. Esta escena de crimen es suya. Teniente.
Donald Lucas is guilty. How can you expect me to make a deal?
I don't expect you.
I mean, the trial starts in an hour, Paul.
Every circumstantial case, there's an element of risk. All I'm saying is the defense may be open to a negotiation.
No.
Look, it's still going to result in years behind bars, and it may be the best we can
get.
No,
that's not enough.
Look, going for murder one may be emotionally satisfying.
That's not the point, okay?
If you make this an all-or-nothing deal, he could walk. So what if we call it murder two or guilt by reason of insanity? Is all this more important than seeing him sent to prison? Both want the same thing, Sam.
When you entered the home of Dr. Dexter Nelson, what did you discover?
Dr. Nelson was found strapped to a dining room table. Two incisions had been made in his lower back, and his kidneys had been removed. It was as if he'd been operated on.
And what was the relationship between Agent Waters and Dr. Nelson?
He was the physician who delivered Samantha Waters.
Did the killer leave anything behind at the scene?
Yes, a note written to Sam, viewable only beneath a black light, a technique which later became a signature of Jack of all trades.
Were there notes left at other crime scenes addressed to Samantha Waters?
Following the murder of Dr. Nelson, there were notes left at each subsequent murder, many of whom were people from Sam's childhood. It's as if his intention was to eliminate her past.
Objection, Your Honor. Conjecture.
Sustained.
And in May of 1993, who else was added to his list of victims?
Tom Waters, her husband.
I have no further questions.
Is there a handwriting analysis done of these notes?
It was concluded that they were all written by the same person.
Did the defendant submit a sample of his handwriting?
Yes.
Did it match?
Results were inconclusive.
Inconclusive. And once the defendant was in custody, did the blacklight notes stop?
They did.
Did the killings stop?
They did.
Philip Menzies, Norm Abbott, Ted Scowron of Otis, California.
Three victims that were killed by Dwight Parnell, a disciple of Donald Lucas.
A disciple. How do you know?
He left the red rose at the crime scenes.
Wasn't that a signature of Jack of all trades?
Yes.
And where is Dwight Parnell today?
He was killed attacking Dr. Waters in an act of justifiable homicide.
Killed by whom?
By Agent George Fraley.
So, an agent for the VCTF killed someone who may actually have been the real Jack of all trades.
Objection. Speculation. Agent Malone has detailed the relationship between the defendant and Dwight Parnell, a relationship which prosecution will corroborate through the testimony of Sheriff Edwin Bost of Otis, California.
I'll sustain the objection. Mr. Meschel?
I have no further questions of this witness at this time, Your Honor.
Very well. This court will break for noon recess.
It won't be long now, Sam. They'll all know the truth. The truth about us all.
People have been disappearing in that stretch of desert for 300 years. Isn't exactly a safe place to be, especially at night.
Well, these women didn't disappear, Sheriff Delman. They were murdered.
We're establishing a base of operations at the motel.
I got you set up at the border inn, just up the highway. Decent coffee shop. American TV, phones, water. None of that sludge they drink over there. No offense.
I'm Cuban.
We'd like your missing persons files going back to the beginning of the year.
We don't have any missing persons. So how'd this situation come to your attention?
It was mailed to me anonymously.
Well, these are police photos. Now, did you talk to the law on their side?
Not yet. You know the chief of police of Las Brisas?
Yeah. Miguel Vila Lobos, more politician than lawman, is my impression. Dresses better than any cop I've ever known. Present company excluded.
You have a run-in with this guy or something?
I know who he is, but I don't know him. Let's just say I do what I can to keep their problems on their side. Good fences make good neighbors.
The bites are consistent with wolves and coyotes, and the tears are probably vultures. I'd say she's between 18 and 20 years of age, dead about 36 hours. Retinal petechiae and bruises are consistent with manual strangulation. I don't know yet if there's a pattern. Doesn't look like anyone's ever examined them.
Not much left to examine by the time we find them.
She's wearing this?
It was pinned to her blouse.
What about the other victims? Did they have similar jewelry?
Earrings, maybe. A necklace, it varied.
Or costume? I'd like to see the rest of that if I could.
I'll have to ask Vila Lobos.
He could have given them these to distract them so they wouldn't put up a struggle.
We don't know if they struggled or not.
Lieutenant, I was sent this packet with newspaper articles, photographs, all about the murders. Do you have any idea who would have sent them?
No.
What about this? Do you recognize this little girl? I think that her mother could be one of the victims.
I'm sorry, I don't know all the children in town.
Well, I'd like to see your files.
I'll get you what we've got.
Okay.
Is it me? Or does she seem a little blasé about everything?
Grace, can you determine if there was any sexual trauma?
Yeah. A couple hours.
Okay, great. Thanks.
These girls come from villages all over the desert looking for work. They come into town, see the city for the first time, dancing, drinking. They look for a way to mix business and pleasure.
Prostitution.
I do what I can to keep it down, but people have to feed their babies.
It says here that a lot of the victims worked at the factory.
Unsubstantiated reports. I don't even have IDs on these girls.
No leads from your interviews with Lofton employees?
The factory has a large turnover. The workers show up whenever they feel like it. They're not very reliable.
So there were no interviews conducted at all?
The more people you talk to, the more they panic. It's very hard to investigate.
Well, with all due respect, it doesn't seem like there's very much of an investigation going on.
We do the best we can.
We'd like to go back over your reports. Help establish a volunteer program to escort women who travel the desert at night.
Pidieron copias.
Whatever is ours is theirs.
I would also like to go out to where the latest victim was found.
Don't forget your sunblock.
Great. Thank you.
Yeah, Lobos.
It's JD.
They were just here.
What were we gonna do?
Nothing. Just go along with it. And get rid of them as soon as possible.
Federal agents don't scare so easy. Our friend isn't gonna like this.
Most of the bodies were found between here and the river. Maybe 15 miles.
He feels in control here. Samantha Waters.
Got definite signs of sexual activity shortly before death. I'd say within 6 hours.
How definite?
Definite enough to send a DNA sample to the lab. The other victims are so far gone, we'll never be able to tell.
All right, yeah, thanks. He may have had sex with the victims before he killed them.
Does that surprise you?
Yeah, it does. Sexual predators usually don't give their victims gifts. How soon can I get the rest of the jewelry?
It's missing from lockup.
Oh. Look, somebody in the department must have had access to that jewelry.
It wasn't stolen.
Lieutenant, do you have any idea where it could be?
No, I don't.
Look, you know, if you're not comfortable talking to me here, we can go into Ferguson.
I don't go into Ferguson. You people will be here for a short time. Maybe you'll find the killer, maybe you won't. Either way, you'll leave with a clear conscience than when you came.
Yeah, but isn't that what this is about, living here unafraid? Lieutenant, it was the girl in the picture. She was wearing a white dress and white tennis shoes. Yes, I know how many little girls here wear white dresses, but... Yes, across the street from the market. Okay. Yeah, thank you, Lieutenant.
Maybe Marcia doesn't want to go behind her boss's back.
I haven't asked her to. I think she's afraid of him. I mean, she's afraid of something.
Well, Sam, she's the only woman on the force, which makes her an island in the sea of machismo. Victim number 10, and there are 16 missing persons reports on file. You can take half of those out of the running because of gender and age. And I'm still going to need those dental records to confirm IDs, assuming there are records. Maybe if I got my hands on some modeling clay, I could give them faces.
Victims were all poor, young. You may have used these to lure them in. Although I still get the feeling that he wants to dominate them, you know, like a lord over their lives.
I think of everybody who works here as a member of the family.
Your family consists mostly of females between 18 and 35. Why is that, Mr. Lofton?
Women are more reliable. They have children to take care of, and they take that responsibility very seriously.
How much do you pay them?
A lot less than if we were on the other side of the border, but about three times what they were making before I got here. At least now they can support their children.
What about unionization?
We get a troublemaker every now and then, but he's usually shouted down by the others. Afraid everybody's job will disappear.
To the extent of murder?
Not very likely. Unionization is not in their blood. These people care about food and clothing and trying to keep a roof over their head.
So who has time to file a lawsuit? No wonder you decided to pick up stakes and move down here.
I don't really give a damn about the lawsuits. Nothing but a bunch of lazy opportunists trying to take advantage of my friendly disposition. I just got so sick and tired of everything I do and say being scrutinized by lawyers. Down here, they're grateful for the opportunity to work. Now that's what I call a refreshing concept.
I thought it was called shooting fish in a barrel.
Your factory operates around the clock. The murders were all committed between midnight and 2 a.m. Would you consider shutting down nighttime operations until we find the killer? If the women didn't have to be out at those hours.
I provide lighted parking areas for those who have cars, those who don't. I bus back and forth to town at my expense. I cannot compete globally if I can't operate 24 hours a day.
The killer could be someone who's in a position of authority who views his victims as subservient, as if they were his children. Or he could be at the bottom of a power structure and merely wants to dominate those people who are weaker than he is.
Lofton said he liked to think of his work as his family. He sees his role in their lives as more than just an employer. Or someone who takes care of them.
James Lofton, man's worth a fortune.
Money doesn't always eliminate suspicion, Sheriff Tolman.
I know, but I just can't see a man in his position venturing out in the desert in his custom-made suits to kill those girls.
Where are we on the DNA?
Waiting.
You got a DNA sample from the body?
It's off to the lab.
Let's say that the killer is in a position of prominence. Having sex with these women is their death sentence. He doesn't want to run the risk of being exposed or blackmailed.
Play, you pay. Just the expression. Civic-minded of you warning the ladies like this.
It was Padilla's idea. I let him run with it.
How much does Martin know?
Nothing. Even if she did, she's smart enough to keep her mouth shut.
That's good, because the DNA they got off that girl was sent to their FBI lab in Washington. She one of Lofton's honeys?
How should I know?
I was under the impression you knew everything on your side.
He's your countryman.
But it's your country. Hey, would you lighten up? It's getting so you can't take a damn joke anymore. And you're not the one killing him, are you?
Maybe I should talk to Lofton about this DNA business. He's got friends.
I don't really care whether he's doing these girls or not. I'm just not inclined to see him caught. I don't relish the idea of having to live on my paycheck, do you?
All these women. For a year, no one's cared.
Yeah, if this had happened in Buckhead, Scarsdale, or Beverly Hills, they would have called out the National Guard by now. It's not about morality, it's about geography. Same all over. Never said life was fair. No one ever said that it was. When do you leave?
An hour.
Sheriff Bost is on the stand. Why do they need you to hear his testimony?
Well, Paul's a little worried about cross-examination. He wants me there to consult on redirect if need be. I'll be back tonight. Is that your son? He's beautiful.
Thank you.
An only child?
Yes.
I have a little girl. Look, Lieutenant.
Marta.
We'll find whoever we're looking for without involving you.
Sheriff Bost, did you have reason to believe that Ted Scowron, Norm Abbott, and Philip Menzies were killed by Dwight Parnell?
Yes, sir, I did.
And did Dwight Parnell ever communicate with Donald Lucas?
Yes, sir. On a computer owned by the late Philip Menzies.
And had Dwight Parnell ever shown any signs of violence or homicidal tendencies prior to that communication?
Anything but. The idea of killing disgusted him. He was a good bowler, an environmentalist, and a vegetarian. Dwight Parnell was morally opposed to eating anything that had a face.
Carry on, Mr. Sterling.
I have no further questions, Your Honor.
Fact is, you have no idea what's on Philip Menzies' computer, do you?
I know that whatever was on it caused Dwight Parnell to kill all those people.
But you do not know what is on it.
No, sir, I don't.
And isn't it true that when you first met Dr. Warder, she'd already decided that there was a link between the defendant and persons in Otis, California?
Not to my knowledge.
Didn't she do everything possible to sway the investigation so that it would satisfy a conclusion she'd already reached?
Now, just a darn minute. I will not have you question the integrity of Dr. Samantha Waters. She is an ethical, responsible member of the law enforcement community that has suffered unspeakable tragedy at the hands of this Donald Lucas or Jack of all trades or whatever the hell he's calling
himself
now.
Your Honor, the witness is unresponsive.
The jury will disregard the speech that was volunteered by Sheriff Bost.
Your Honor, he is an obsessive personality, a menace to society.
One more outburst like that and I'll place your tush in contempt. The jury will disregard. We'll take a recess of 1 hour, during which time, Mr. Sterling, I suggest you get control of your witness.
Don't worry, Dr. Waters. The judge tells the jury to disregard all the time, but they never do. Maybe you'll come back to Otis and visit sometime.
Maybe I will.
It's all gonna go just fine.
She's been dead about 12 hours. That puts the last two attacks within a few days of each other.
Do you have a timeline on the others to develop a pattern of attacks?
We're not dealing with the carbon dating of T-Rexes. These are people. Even the oldest of skeletons have to be guessed at visually.
Any sexual component?
Not only didn't she have sex prior to death, she's a virgin.
Sam lands in an hour.
Well, I'm not going anywhere.
Somebody left DNA on that girl they found the other day.
Well, it wasn't me.
If our relationship is not going to be based on trust...
Our relationship is based on that overstuffed envelope you get every week.
You get your money's worth. Any complaints?
Why are you telling me this?
The FBI thinks you killed those girls.
What? Who told you that, Tallman? Hey, don't play cutesy with me. You're in this as deep as I am.
Maybe, but I like my odds a lot better. I could arrest someone.
What did that cost me, huh?
Whatever I decide is worth.
¿De dónde sacaste esta basura?
Atrás de Celestinas. Dicen que resistió arresto.
Ah, es una ofensa grave. No tan grave como asesinato.
So you bring him in?
Ah, yes. Good news. You can go home now. We have the man responsible for these crimes. His name is Ernesto Garcia.
He looks half dead.
Unfortunately, he resisted the attempts of our officers to take him into custody.
How do you know he's responsible?
He's got guilt written all over his face.
For a year, Villalobos has no case. 2 days after we arrive, he produces a suspect.
He's a pretty good candidate. 6 drunken disorderlies, assault. Did a year for almost choking a prostitute to death. He's perfect.
Too perfect. Villalobos is protecting someone.
Lofton?
It's even money.
He feels the need to dominate. Probably because he's been dominated in his life, victimized. Maybe not physically, but emotionally. I mean, he could feel diminished with women.
Lofton's married, a trophy from what I hear.
The suspect has been married 3 times.
Grace said that the last victim was a virgin.
One he had sex with, one he didn't.
That's if we're assuming that the man who left the sample is the killer.
Maybe the sex was convenient. It was just about the killing.
Yeah, but then why would he leave the jewelry? Maybe there's some sort of sexual dysfunction stemming from his being diminished or humiliated.
Still don't know who sent you the package. Lieutenant.
Ernesto Garcia, the suspect in custody, is innocent.
How do you know?
At the time of her death, I was questioning him on the other side of town.
Have you told Villalobos?
No. Ernesto has a son in Juarez. The money I give him in exchange for information he sends to his boy, I mail it to him myself.
Who is Villalobos protecting?
Lofton, maybe. Members of Los Desmandados. The gang in town run by Raul Ortiz.
Who's Ortiz?
Local dealer. Recruits young women into prostitution. The ones he can't recruit, he extorts for money in exchange for a job at the factory.
One-stop misogyny.
Is there any way of clearing Ernesto without involving you?
There's a bar on the east end of town, Ocho Caballos. A man named Valdez owns the place. He saw us there.
John.
When Villalobos questions Ernesto, he is not a strong man. He'll break.
And we'll have nothing.
Malone.
Martha.
I couldn't keep quiet any longer.
You know, we can protect you.
I'll be fine.
State Department. They want to talk to me first thing in the morning.
No one will know that you've been here.
Dime. Tú lo hiciste. Vamos, cabrón, dime.
Por favor, para. Oh, Dios mío, para.
Pararé cuando me digas lo que quiero saber.
No fui yo, te lo juro, te lo juro.
Es mi macho, ¿eh? Te daré más.
¡No aguanto más!
¿Lo quieres matar? ¿O que hable?
Quiero que te calles y que hagas lo que yo digo. Tienes un uniforme puesto y te quedarás en él hasta que aprendas cómo se juega este jueguito.
You want me to back off?
They have a credible suspect.
They have a drunk whose standard of living goes up in prison.
Agent Malone, the Mexican government is perfectly capable of handling its own police matters.
We're there by special arrangement of the Attorney General of Mexico.
A gesture that expires the minute your actions surpass the scope of that invitation.
Which is when? The minute we start to suspect the largest employer of Mexican labor of murder?
James Lofton is a pioneer. He operates a dozen American concerns in full compliance with NAFTA trade agreements.
He's a potential killer. Hiding behind two decades of hard-fought legislation in order to exploit and possibly murder a dozen women.
You are a guest, Agent Malone. You're there to observe.
And what I observe is that no one seems to give a damn about those women. And I'm beginning to understand why.
To assume the Mexican government is corrupt and therefore incapable of handling its own investigation is not only arrogant, it is racist. And I will not let you misrepresent the American people if I have to assert my full authority of the State Department over you.
Meaning what?
You know perfectly well what I mean.
Are you ordering us to leave Mexico?
I'm asking you to consider the best interest of everyone.
Well, consider this. We're not leaving till we get the results of that DNA. If it matches his suspect, we're out of there. If not...
What do you mean the DNA never got there? Yeah, okay. I'll get back to you.
14 years, I've never had DNA vanish.
I made it to D.C. fine.
Well, let me guess. Pilot handed it over to an agent from the State Department.
And no one will remember his name.
I'll get his name. I've still got a few markers on the hill.
Yeah, well, before you cash him in, I have another sample.
Racy, you're beautiful.
Yeah, I know.
Lofton's the only one around here with that kind of clout.
Yeah, but it doesn't prove that he's the killer. He could have arranged for the sample to be lost so he could save himself from a sexual scandal.
Here you go.
I'll make sure this doesn't vanish. I'll have one of our people hand deliver it to the lab in D.C.
It still only proves that he had sex with one of the victims, Bailey, and it could have been consensual.
If it is Lofton's DNA, I want to know why the State Department's trying to protect that son of a bitch.
A ganar $50 a la semana trabajando en la fábrica.
Oh, es mucho dinero.
Pero claro, van a haber deducciones. Mira, 20 para mí por el trabajo.
¿Cómo puedo firmar? Mantener a mi familia con $30.
¿Y cómo lo vas a mantener sin nada? Puedo conseguir hasta 50 muchachas y me hacen lo que sea por este jodido trabajo. Bueno, dígame, ¿quieres el trabajo o no? Bueno.
I'll have the results of the DNA within 24 hours. Mm-hmm. Lois thought she's good about the turnaround.
Mm-mm. No, George, you're gonna be fine. Yeah. All right, I'll see you tomorrow. He's nervous about testifying. Paul's been grilling him.
It's not Paul he has to worry.
What am I looking at?
The spot where I've been banging my head against the wall for the last 2 hours.
I couldn't get anybody to confirm Marta's alibi for the suspect. The guy who owns the saloon, who said he saw them?
All of a sudden, he's tight as a clam.
Well, Marta wouldn't have risked coming to us if she was lying. She's got too much to lose.
Suspect won't be able to hold out much longer. Villalobos will have his confession and we'll have no grounds to stay.
Maybe this isn't just about emotional diminishment. Maybe it's about heartbreak.
Well, he's certainly causing plenty of it.
Well, he gives them trinkets, tokens of his love. I mean, maybe that's what he wants in return. Not necessarily sex, but something more emotional, something romantic.
Someone ought to tell this guy that women like to be wined and dined.
Well, whether he just wanted romance or if he's sexually dysfunctional, how do you explain the DNA on the victim?
Maybe there were two men, you know, I mean... Like, I don't know. I mean, the evidence is compromised and we have no background on the victims. We don't even know who the victims are.
We only have one element, Sam. You're still our strongest card.
I'll be right back.
Went to the ladies' room an hour ago. She's gone.
Maybe she went for a walk in the desert.
A United States federal agent is missing, possibly abducted. I want to search the ploy to every man on your department on it.
I can't. It's Friday night.
I don't care if it's Palm Sunday. If I have to, I'll call the Attorney General.
Well, you can try.
Look, we're here to help solve a series of vicious crimes affecting your people. A joint effort between both our countries.
You're here because you're worried about how an American company is going to look when the story breaks out about dead Mexican workers.
You think we only exist to search for the almighty buck. Now's your chance to prove it. If an American's responsible for what's going on here, no one wants to nail his ass more than I do.
Still no word?
Contact Tallman. Get every available officer on the U.S. side over here as quickly as possible.
You're overstepping
my boundaries extend as far as I say they do, the minute she disappeared.
Buen día. Esto es para Gracia. Gracias.
Soy inocente. Te lo juro, no fui yo. Por favor. No.
There's a monster in this town, Agent Waters.
Some people say that it's you.
No.
Look, abducting me is not going to help your case any.
I had no choice. The investigation is going nowhere.
You've been following the investigation?
Very closely.
Why?
I'm the one who brought you here. In the envelope were 6 pictures from the police department and 4 articles from the newspaper, all with dates written in pencil in the upper right corner.
How did you get the photographs?
I'm resourceful.
What about the little girl?
She's my niece. I believe the man you're looking for killed my sister.
Thank you for helping us.
What's your name?
Consuela.
Consuela. Mucho gusto, Consuela.
My sister disappeared 9 months ago. One of the first. The man Villalobos has in custody, this Garcia, he's nothing.
We know.
There are files in his office, locked in his office. You need them before Garcia confesses and the books are closed.
How do we get them?
Oh, you need to be resourceful. And now, you can go.
Just like that?
Yeah, he dropped me off at the border checkpoint.
You believe him?
Yeah, I think I do.
Someone on the Las Brisas department must be on the pad. That's got to be how he got those pictures in the first place. Martha?
She would have told me by now. Those files have got to be in a more secure place, or he'd have used the same source.
Ernesto Garcia confessed to the murders. He'll be hanged for them.
Get me Dennis Gilmore at the State Department field office.
Letting him escape is not the answer. And even if we assume legal custody, he's confessed, he'll still have to stand trial. No, our only hope is if we find the killer before that happens.
Are you going to do that? Villalobos has the Attorney General's ear. He controls whether you stay or go.
Well, Ortiz told me about a file that your boss has locked in his office, all about the murders. Now, I just need 10 minutes alone in that room.
No, it's too dangerous.
Look, if he's withholding information, there has to be a reason.
I'll do it.
No.
He'll kill you.
And he won't kill you?
Then we'll do it together.
Hola, nena, ¿cómo estás? Mira, hablamos después, ¿eh?
Your call was a pleasant surprise. You know, your boss was very worried over your disappearance.
Wow. We look after each other.
I can see why he looks after you. So, what can I do for you besides buy you a drink?
I want you to let us stay.
The suspect has already confessed.
Yes, but we both know he didn't do it.
He didn't fit your profile. That doesn't mean he didn't do it.
In a few weeks, when the killing resumes, how will you explain it?
That's the beautiful thing about my job, Dr. Waters. I don't have to explain. Anything you want. I have nothing to hide. So, you think that I've got the wrong man. You tell me, who killed these women?
Well, in order to tell you that, I need more time.
Who fits your profile?
Lofton, Ortiz.
Ortiz is a slippery bastard, but he didn't kill these women.
What about Lofton?
Not as slippery, but still a bastard. Why do I get the feeling that there's more than you're telling me?
Because you are a very perceptive man.
Someone else fits your profile?
Possibly.
And who would that be? Let's say that a man in my position was responsible for these crimes. What would his motivation be?
To exercise his power.
Power, yes. The ultimate in, ¿cómo se dice la palabra? Aphrodisia.
Especially for those who have to prove that they have it.
And in this exercise, he finds his gratification.
Well, I think that this man wants to not only gratify himself, but the women that he's with.
He cares about them.
In his own way, yeah.
And you believe that I have this sense of caring?
Well, you're drawn to women.
To that, I plead guilty, yeah.
And you want to please them?
In my culture, it is considered an art.
So women want you, and men fear you.
And then I have become a figure of legend. And you think that's what I am? Tú eres una mujer muy hermosa. But we both know that I am just a policeman in the service of his people. So I should let you stay so that you can hunt down this man. So you want to find the killer among us? Agent Waters, how badly do you want to find this killer?
So he gave you another 24 hours?
Oh, I was afraid to ask her anymore. I all but told him that he was our prime suspect.
How do you react?
Like a man who relished the attention.
Why didn't Ortiz kill Lofton if he knew about his sister?
Well, I don't think he did know, not for sure.
Does Lofton fit the profile?
Well, both Villalobos and Lofton fit pieces of it. Villalobos could have killed these women because he could prove that Lofton was sleeping with him. Right? It's obvious that Villalobos was blackmailing Lofton.
Unless I've screwed this up, here's one we can identify.
I recognize her. That's Ortiz's sister.
We just found Consuela's mother.
Los mensajes como a las 12 de la noche y él todavía estaba aquí.
No pudo salirse, solo alguien lo sacó.
Vi una luz en tu oficina, pero no era nada. ¿Se lo informo al FBI?
No. No le digas nada.
Rápido. Enough money to get you to Chicago, okay?
Sí.
You get on the bus. You don't look back. No? Okay.
Sí.
Gracias.
Good.
Gracias.
Vámonos, vámonos.
Preocupe, no se pone más fácil.
¿Qué pasó con García?
El sospechoso, él ya se fue.
¿Dónde se fue?
Bueno, yo lo llevé hasta la frontera. Después de eso, yo no sé.
Creo que Villalobos tiene que encontrar otro asesino. Quizás el verdadero esta vez.
CTF confiscated the defendant's computer. Were you able to make a connection between the defendant, Donald Lucas, and the victims of Jack of All Trades?
Objection. Counsel is attempting to mislead the jury. Donald Lucas and Jack of All Trades are one and the same.
Sustained.
I'll rephrase. Were you able to make a connection between the defendant, Donald Lucas, and the victims?
I found evidence to support the fact that Donald Lucas had hacked into the hospital records, the bank and insurance files, and even the IRS and Social Security records of some of the victims.
And what was this evidence, Agent Fraley?
Remnant data strings. Excuse me, ghosting is what we call it.
And what is a remnant data string?
It's an image lifted off of the surface of a hard drive left behind during the process of erasure.
And is there a measure of density to this image which you must have in order to conclude certainty?
A density of 5.06 is necessary.
And did these ghostings have this density?
The defendant had built into his erasure program a silicone emollient which renders testing of its density impossible.
So you were unable to determine if the ghostings had the necessary density?
Mr. Lucas wanted to avoid detection and destroy evidence that probably linked him to the murder victims.
Your Honor, the witness is making a speculation.
Stick to the question, Agent Fraley.
No, they did not have this measure of density.
So you were not able to make any link between the defendant and any of the 43 victims the defendant is accused of killing?
No.
I have no further questions, Your Honor.
You must have a lot to keep you busy at home.
More than enough, I'm afraid.
Then why come here?
That's why.
Bastardo la mató antes de atraparlo. El tiempo lo indica perfecto.
He says the suspect they had in custody must have killed her before he was caught.
You don't believe that?
No more than you do.
Gracie.
I'll know better after a full exam, but I'd say that she's been dead at least 18 hours prior to discovery.
Ernesto was still in jail.
Was she sexually attacked?
I wouldn't say attacked, but there was sex.
Let's get the body back to the morgue. Have Sam take a look as soon as she gets back. Couldn't have gotten out of jail without help.
Things happen in this town that no one can explain.
But no one can, or no one will.
Rides like a dream. Don't you love it?
I wanted a convertible.
Mrs. Lofton. Mr. Lofton, buenos dias.
And what can I do for you, Miguel?
I'm gonna go change, okay?
I hope you came to tell me that you recaptured that escaped suspect. I know you didn't let him go, Miguel. That would have been stupid. You're not stupid.
I wish I was more well-read.
Don't ever confuse education with intelligence. Somebody left that cell door open. There's one person in your department that you can't control.
She owes me her livelihood.
And you think that translates into what? Loyalty? As far as women go, the word doesn't exist.
Marta would never turn on me.
Listen, I don't care whether you're sleeping with her or not, but there's a person in your department whose interests don't coincide with ours. Take care of it soon, Miguel. Take care of it quietly. What did you come to tell me?
Oh, they found another DNA sample. Nice car.
George's testimony didn't help. They destroyed every direct link that he tried to make between Donald Lucas and the murders.
So we're left with circumstantial.
Mm-hmm. He could walk. A week ago, I wouldn't have thought this was possible.
Look, cases are made every day on circumstantial, and far less than what we have.
I can't let him walk, man.
You know how brutal testifying is going to be.
Yeah, I do.
I sat outside Lofton's office all day. He never moved. We got the pictures of him and the women. Why don't we just drag him in here?
They were obtained illegally. The minute the DNA confirms he had sex with the murder victims, we'll confront him, but not before.
We're turning up more bodies every hour.
Another one last night out in the desert. They were trying to lay it on Garcia, but that...
Garcia?
He escaped, Sam. Villalobos isn't being helpful with the details.
We'll get some pictures of Garcia distributed along the border. If he tries to cross over, we'll grab him pretty quick.
Race is working on the latest victim.
Yeah, I'll head over there. Just give me a minute.
Duerme bien, mi corazón.
Tú no vas a trabajar esta noche, ¿verdad?
No.
Qué bueno.
Convénceme que no lo dejaste escapar.
Esta es mi casa.
Qué hermoso reza. Convénceme.
No lo dejé escapar.
No me has convencido. Yo te quiero creer.
Créame o no.
Ay, Mara, I'm sorry that it's late.
Four hours are up.
Your suspects escaped.
And we'll find them.
If anything happens to her.
If you think that you can come into my country and threaten me, Agent Waters. Have a very pleasant evening, ladies.
He thinks I let Garcia go. And so do you. But I didn't.
Well, then who did? Look, Marta, if you're afraid for yourself and your son, we can arrange entry into the United States.
He won't do anything to me as long as you're here.
We won't always be here.
Then we have to find the killer before you leave.
What if we don't?
I was born here. And I have a job to do, if only to prove that they can't make me run away. Can you understand that?
Yeah. Yeah. Any sexual contact?
Within a few hours of death, there's nothing like a consistent MO to keep things simple. So are we back to the idea of a sexual predator?
I can't help thinking that this goes beyond a strictly physical urge.
You don't see that many Latinas with this kind of dye job. I can say that and still remain PC.
Well, he knows that he can't be with them forever, but maybe he keeps hoping that his fantasy of some long-term relationship will become a reality.
You know I can't stand long goodbyes.
We still have more time.
I'm meeting James for an early dinner. Come on, get out of bed. Gotta change the sheets.
Nothing like performing on command.
Oh, stop whining.
Did you ever think of the possibility that I may be in love with you? Is that so crazy?
Maybe not for you.
Your husband can't give you what I can. He can't give you anything at all.
So what am I supposed to do? Walk away from the house, the car, everything? For a guy who makes 12 grand a year, including kickbacks? Hey, easy, Pedro. You know, we can call a halt to this altogether. He's home. You gotta get out of here.
Yeah.
Oh, I suspected this. You sleeping with my wife.
Someone should.
It was you, wasn't it? You're the one who's been killing all those girls.
Why would I kill your girlfriends? You know, I'm only keeping the feds around to watch you squirm. From anything now, huh?
We arrived within 5 minutes of Mrs. Lofton's call. Rapid response is a point of pride. He was trying to achieve prosperity for our people.
He didn't do too badly for himself.
No.
Where's your ballistics lab?
It won't be necessary.
I want that bullet tested. He was an American citizen.
In my country. We have a pretty good idea who the killer was. Raul Ortiz. His sister was one of the victims. He believed Lofton was responsible.
Well, if you hurry, you can still beat a confession out of him before dinner.
You have another suspect in mind?
You got a reason why I shouldn't suspect you?
He was my lover and my best friend.
I'm sorry for your loss.
Everyone loved Jimmy.
Mrs. Lofton, you said that you were reading.
Uh-huh.
So you didn't see or hear anyone just before the gun went off?
I just heard the shot.
How long did it take before the police got here?
About 20 minutes after I called.
She's having an affair.
My money's on Villalobos. You said the response time was 5 minutes. She told you 20. That's too big a gap. Lofton fits your profile. He was humiliated by his wife's affair, emotionally diminished. So he takes his revenge out on these other women.
Well, Villalobos could be the one who's humiliated.
Humiliated? You've seen Lofton's wife.
Yeah, but Villalobos is only there to service her. I mean, she'd never have left her husband for him. And I don't think she had a problem letting him know that.
Malone. Tell him we're 20 minutes out. It's our buddy at the State Department.
Now, I don't think you understand the ramifications here.
I understand you tried to put a muzzle on us. And now you've got a dead industrialist whose DNA, despite your efforts to obstruct justice, was found on the bodies of two murdered women.
I had nothing to do with that disappearance. Anyway, you found what you were looking for? Does that make Lofton the killer?
Not necessarily. It may have turned him into a victim.
You want to clear Lofton because it makes life easier for you. We want the killer, whether it's Lofton or Villalobos.
What? I'm ready to deal.
Call the Attorney General in Mexico City. Get me a warrant to obtain Villalobos' gun.
Give me a reason.
Villalobos was blackmailing Lofton. He had taken dozens of photographs of Lofton with various young women, at least one of whom has turned up as a murder victim.
Well, that makes Villalobos a suspect in the murders.
Mm-hmm. He fits the profile.
Get me the Attorney General.
¿Tienes el dinero?
Sí, lo tengo.
¿Por qué tienes miedo? Yo estaré contigo.
No sé por qué.
¿Quieres cruzar la frontera y salir de este pueblucho?
Sí, más que nada.
Confía en mí. Yo te protegeré.
Está bien.
Ten el dinero listo. Ya sabes dónde encontrarlo.
Sí.
Mucha gente.
Está bien.
I'd like your sidearm.
Get out of my office.
Your sidearm.
Son of a bitch. You're investigating me for murder in my town. While you're at it, why don't you dust footprints and find out who broke into my office the other night? I'd like to get my hands on him.
Our warrant includes a search of your private residence. We can go there next if you'd like.
Lofton's body has been moved to a lab across the border. We'll have the results by morning.
Why would Villa-Lobos kill Lofton if he was blackmailing Lofton?
He was sleeping with Lofton's wife. We believe the discovery of their affair led to the killing.
I saw Villa-Lobos earlier. He was with a girl. She was pretty, about 20.
We should put a tail on him.
You can try, but he won't tail easily. And if he makes you, I'll keep an eye out for her. Hopefully she'll stay at home, out of trouble.
Okay, well, in spite of these killings, nightlife is remaining active. Sheriff, maybe you could run some patrols along the border, starting at dusk right on through the night.
We haven't been having any troubles on this side.
And I'd like to do everything we can to keep it that way. Excuse me.
I'll get right on that.
I am sorry for what I said when you first came here, about trying to clear your conscience. You care about this very much. How do you explain to your daughter why you care?
My daughter has experienced tragedy in a way that I hope your son never does. She understands.
I want him to understand.
I'm sure he will.
¿Estás seguro aquí?
Estoy esperando a alguien.
¿A quién?
A Sheriff Villa-Lobos.
¿Sheriff?
Dr. Waters, did it take you to bring the defendant into custody?
7 years.
Long time. Couldn't have been trying very hard if it took you 7 years.
Your Honor, counsel's opinion of how hard the witness was trying has no relevance.
Sustained.
Isn't it a fact, Dr. Waters, that it took you 7 years because on some level you actually enjoyed being the object of this alleged obsession Mr. Lucas had for you?
No.
One of the premier profilers for the FBI, and yet it took you 7 years to bring this man in. I just find that kind of hard.
Objection asked and answered.
Would you like it read back to you?
Your Honor, may I? I didn't enjoy living my life in a prison. I didn't enjoy depriving my child of a normal childhood. Chloe. My daughter. Sorry. My daughter has no memories of going to the park or playing in the playground because she never did. We have lived our lives in a state of fear due to the constant threat posed by the defendant.
But the fact is, Mr. Lucas never did threaten you, did he?
Yes, he did. He broke into my house.
And how did he do that? You yourself described it as a prison.
I don't know.
What happened?
He left me a note.
What kind of note?
It was the lyrics to a song that we sang in Sunday school.
That's a threat?
It was an attempt to create a psychological environment that would...
I didn't ask for your opinion of the defendant's motive.
Mr. Meschel. You opened this can. Besides, she's qualified. Go on.
Thank you. It was an attempt to create an environment of fear that would render me and my daughter psychologically vulnerable.
To what end?
I don't know.
You're qualified, Dr. Waters. To what end?
Objection. He is badgering the witness.
To what end? This is the end.
The defendant will sit down.
The defendant confesses to the acts with which he is charged so that the abuse of this woman will end. This woman,
Your Honor, may we have a recess?
Shut up, Jeff.
Order, Mr. Meschel.
Your Honor, this man has no right to represent me.
He
wouldn't recognize love if it bit him in the ass.
Mr. Meschel, if you're angling for an incompetency plea.
We met in the shadow of his cross, and I have carried it my whole life. Even though I've committed what they call crimes, I feel no guilt. Those lives meant nothing. They were simply a conduit that led you to me. Bound us together through the mystic cords of memory. Inseparable. Sharing one mind, one consciousness, one soul.
Your Honor, I need to speak to my client.
Order! Order!
I could feel it all slipping away. The entire case, and then he just jumped up and he confessed.
To everything, unequivocally?
Yeah. Then his lawyer started angling for diminished capacity.
He doesn't belong in an institution. He deserves to be strapped to the chair.
I have to go back in 3 days for a sentencing.
Nightmare's over, sir.
In 3 days, it'll be over.
Marta was shot last night, but she's holding on.
Why didn't you call me?
I didn't want that hanging over you, what do you understand?
Was it Villalobos?
We don't know. She was in the desert, shot with her own gun. Based on the footprints, she tried to stop an attack.
Marta said that she saw him with a girl.
Whoever did it left her for dead. You've got her room guarded at the hospital. Her condition hasn't worsened. We have to believe she'll make it soon.
Can I get anybody anything over the diner?
No, thanks.
Sheriff Tillman, did Villalobos, did he ever talk to you about women? Mrs. Lofton in particular?
All the time. That's why I never believed him. Guy who has to tell the whole world what he's been up to probably hadn't been up to anything. That's why I keep my mouth shut, you know what I'm saying? It's like my daddy used to say. You don't tell people how smart you are. You let them find out for themselves.
Yep, eso sí lo hace. Ah, pinche güey. Ahí está.
¿Cuánto me debes?
20 pesos te tengo que dar, pero no te lo puedo dar esta mañana.
Buenos días, amigos.
I was dumb. Where's your employer?
No good English.
Donde Ortiz?
Okay, okay. We go. We go to Ortiz.
See? Your English wasn't that bad.
Get out of here.
As long as Villalobos was pointing the finger at Ortiz for Lofton's murder, he knew that Ortiz would stay hidden.
I don't want to seem like I'm jumping on the bandwagon, but we always heard things about Villalobos running that town like it was his private playground.
Sheriff, I want you to have as many people as you can spare at the checkpoint tonight between 10 and 11.
Sure, why?
It's all set. Ortiz will be there at 10 in the alley outside the Ocho Caballos Saloon.
Will he have the negatives with him?
And the only copies. Pictures of the killer with those women. We let word slip back to Villalobos.
So he's interested in buying them.
Let me put it this way. See?
That'll close the noose. As soon as Villalobos makes the buy, we grab him.
I'll have every squad car we own right at the checkpoint. If he tries to cross the border, we'll be there for you. I want those negatives, Ortiz. Let's have them.
How much are you willing to pay?
Do you want to live?
What difference does it make? You killed my sister.
Was she one of them? I'm sorry.
Don't move, Sheriff.
Get your hands on your head. On your head!
Hey, Raul, you okay?
Oh. Glad he can aim. Did you get it on tape?
Thank you.
I didn't do it for you.
Give me the Mexican federal authorities.
There were no pictures, were there?
No.
Then how'd you know?
Well, like you said, don't tell him how smart you are. We found out about your divorce, the charges your wife made.
Wasn't true. What she said about me wasn't true.
Let's go.
DNA on the victims. It was Lofton's, right?
Yeah. Tomlin went after these women because he figured if they'd been with Lofton, that they would be easy. They wouldn't judge him. Yes, when he failed to perform with them, that must have been the final humiliation.
A respected member of an American law enforcement community found guilty of serial murder is, well, it's a tragedy.
For everyone.
These gentlemen are here to arrest you for the murder of James Lofton.
We matched the bullet to your gun.
Well, that's impossible. It couldn't have matched my gun.
You used a different gun.
Gracias.
It was Tallman.
Yeah, we know.
Your Honor.
Thank you. Defendant will please rise. Indictment number Z11744, State of Georgia versus Donald Lucas. It is hereby ordered and adjudged that the defendant shall be executed by means of electrocution by the Department of Corrections of the State of Georgia. The order will be lodged with the Penal Department of the State of Georgia, and the defendant will be remanded to the custody of the state prison at Marietta.
Sam, even in death, I'll be with you always.
He wanted this verdict. In death, he finds something that he could never have in life.
But he's wrong. The story ends with his death, as it should have years ago.
Does it? Really, I don't think that I can go back to work right now. I mean, I just need some time.
A buddy of mine owns a cabin. Not much in it but a cot, a sink, and a fireplace. You got your phone?
I got the phone.
I want you to call in every day, in the morning and at night.
Billy, I'm fine.
Chloe's with your father?
No, my father's in Brussels, and Chloe's at soccer camp, Angels watching her, so I have got everything covered.
I told you it wasn't plush.
It's perfect.
I'll go get the other bags.
Okay. Billy.
Thanks.
Hey, Billy, do you have any...
What? No hello?
What are you doing here?
I knew you'd be here.